to the ladies, the fair and the weak. Fair they are, we'll all admit. But who dares call them weak? Our modern girls play as hard and with as much vitality and stamina as any man. How do they do it? Where do they find all that energy? That seemingly inexhaustible store of pep and ginger? What is that whipcord resilience that lets the weaker sex play half the night, then bob up clear-eyed, ready for the next morning's work? This frail creature strikes her typewriter keys about 40,000 times a day. Even an efficiency expert would be staggered by the amount of chasing around and indoor roadwork that the little woman takes as a matter of course. There's the stair-climbing event, for example. Usually accomplished full tilt and with an armload of brooms, mops, blankets, and sundry household paraphernalia. Iron one of hubby's shirts, for instance. The iron may have to be lifted 20 or 30 times. And since a flat iron weighs about as much as a brick, a day's ironing actually uses just about as much muscle as bricklaying. According to the ergometer dial, it takes 18 units of force to push the needle through the cloth just once. In sewing stitch by stitch, that work adds up. Any man will admit that's a lot of work when it's called to his attention in the right way. And this is one way of calling it to his attention. Now let's use that ergometer gadget again to see how much undesirable exercise we've saved this member of the fair and so-called weaker sex. Now the dial shows about 30 units, only a few ounces of push with the vacuum gear shift. And if you stop to think about it, that's a vast improvement when it's multiplied by the amount of expert driving that our American girls do nowadays. Now that the muscle savers are busy cutting down the amount of unnecessary work for women and for men, we'll all have more energy left for playtime. But there are still plenty of jobs left for the ergometer and the work-saving scientists to tackle. Think of all the energy that our charming millions spend in keeping beautiful. And if science is so darn wonderful, why doesn't some genius build a contraption like this?
Someday